Hi, epilepsy treatment can be a tricky subject. So I will give you today 10 tips from the specialized epilepsy clinic that will work for you if you apply them, and make sure to stick until the end because I will give you a bonus tip if those all did not work for you. Tip number one is getting the right medication for the right seizure type. So it is surprisingly that not all seizures and epilepsy types are the same. So we have two major categories. The first one is focal epilepsy, when seizures and electricity are coming from one spot or multiple spots in the brain. And in this type, all the seizure medications can work. However, there is a second type, it's called generalized epilepsy, and in this type, I think of it as all the brain cells are built to seize and the dials of electricity are all excited and have tendency towards having seizures, and usually it's a genetic cause. And in this specific type of epilepsy, if you give some certain seizure medication, the seizure medications can worsen the seizures and worsen the epilepsy type, such as a family of medication called sodium channel blockers like carbamazepine and phenytoin. So you have to choose the right medication. Tip number two, take your seizure medications all the time and on time. So for example, for cholesterol, if you take up to 80% of your medications, things are working well. However, for epilepsy, it is essential to take the medications as prescribed because medications are essential in maintaining the electricity of the brain at a balance. And if you've missed even one dose, sometimes it's enough to cause seizures to come back. So it is important not to miss any dose. And if life happens and you missed a morning dose, for example, take it right when you remember it, in the middle of the day, at lunch, at noon, anytime. And tip number three, if you forgot to take the medications one day, make sure to make it up. So the way you do it is that if you remember during the day, if you forgot the morning dose, take it right when you remember it, anytime during the day, at 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, anytime during the day. And if you forgot to take it the whole day and it's time for the ninth dose, make sure to take double the dose to make it up. And if the whole day passes and you're in the second day and you did not take the whole day worth of medications, in the morning take double the dose, so double but not triple. If you're getting valuable information, please hit the like button and share this video with other people you care about so that everyone will benefit. Tip number four, make sure to keep a seizure calendar. In this calendar, you will write all the information that you had. When you had a seizure, what were the circumstances, if there any trigger that triggered the seizure, if you missed medications, all those information are very important for you and your doctor to track what worked and what did not. So the epilepsy specialized neurologist is called epileptologist. Can you say that like 10 times without making mistakes? Epileptologist, epileptologist, epileptologist. Tip number five, get enough high quality sleep. Sleep is an essential part of treating epilepsy. I think of the brain as a warehouse that works throughout the day, and during the night we clean this warehouse, and you should get 8 hours of nighttime sleep and make sure to keep a good sleep schedule that is predictable and the same every night to get the best results. And discuss with your doctors if you have snoring, if you wake up tired, or if you have sleep apnea, because treating those conditions is essential in getting your seizures under better control. Tip number six is when you start a new seizure medication, make sure to know all the potential side effects to know what to expect. And we start the medication at a small dose and increase gradually to give your body a chance to adapt to it. My Mayo Clinic professor used to tell me that new seizure medications are like having a new pair of shoes. At the beginning, they'll be tight, and after a few days, you'll get used to them. Tip number seven is having enough medications in your system. This is an essential part, and it's a common reason why seizures are not under good control. So when we take seizure medication, we have to push the seizure medicine to the limit and increase the dose appropriately as tolerated so that we can get the seizures under good control. So if you don't push the medicine to the limit, it's like you're biting one bite of the pizza or a sandwich and you expect to get full if you're hungry. So we should take enough medicine to get good control of your seizures. Tip number eight is identify any triggers for your seizures and try to avoid them. Triggers can be strobe light or some stress that is physiological or biological or psychological stress, and other things like if there is any certain food, fever, dehydration, or anything that you can think of that is documented to increase your seizure, you should avoid it so that you don't get seizures. Tip number 9 is essential part, which is treating any underlying psychiatric or psychological conditions such as depression, anxiety, or PTSD. And they are tend to be common in people with epilepsy because both of them, depression and epilepsy, are a network and electricity conditions. And avoid medication that can cause that, such as Keppra, which can cause depression and anxiety or anger. Treatment can be psychotherapy and counseling or medications if needed. And tip number 10 is avoid alcohol because it tends to be a trigger for seizures. It interacts with seizure medications in lots of occasions, and withdrawal from alcohol can cause seizures. So I tell my patients to stay away from alcohol at any cost, and if you need to do it, make sure to take it like just socially and very small, because small amounts, because the line is very blurry between the number 1 and number 10, especially like in a Super Bowl night. So try to avoid alcohol at all. If you do all those treatments and your seizures are still happening, you might be having what we call drug resistant epilepsy. If you try 2 medications and seizures are still happening, and this type of epilepsy is about 30% of the population of epilepsy, it's pretty common. At that time, you need to see the epilepsy specialized center to get evaluated first with EEG and to make sure that you have epilepsy, and look for other alternative treatments that are successful, such as epilepsy surgery or diet therapy. And to learn more about epilepsy surgery and those successful treatments, you can see this video, and see you in the next one.